Hello, hello again, and welcome to another lens and repair and camera repair. Yeah, well, it's not really a repair. I will do this in this video, but I will show you how you can, if you have an old Carl Zeiss Tessar 2.8 45mm and a T-Star with a CU mount. Well, some of those old lenses are really good for making videos or just to use on taking photos. But they have a different mount than, for example, a Nikon or Canon or Fuji or whatever brands there are. The problem is that you cannot really reach the infinity, or maybe sometimes the you are beyond infinity and you would like to, when it stops at infinity, well, it is infinity. So how is it possible to adjust a lens with an adapter to correct infinity? Yeah, if we, for example, take a this is a no-name brand for the CU to my Nikon camera. It will say, if I put my Carl Zeiss lens here on a Nikon adapter and put it on my camera, well, it actually go beyond infinity already at 10 meter. So I would like it to actually be when I go to infinity, set the lens focus range to infinity, it will be infinity and not 10 meter mark. So how to do that? Well, actually, it's quite easy. We need some tools and we have different options. We need to take off the nameplate ring, which is the ring and the nameplate is all in one piece. So you can use those absolutely famous rubber cone tools, very sticky rubber. Or you could, if you have anything else, you could also buy a rubber stopper in those shops who sell stuff for making wine and beer and so on. It's quite sticky. So, and you can get them in many different sizes. Of course, it's completely flat surface here, so I simply dig out with a knife in both end here, so it can act as a lens spinner. Well, so it's fine. So, but we will get off the nameplate, turning counterclockwise, and simply put it on, and then have a good grip, and then unscrew it. So that's it. I mean, of course it's not that simple. It would be nice. But underneath here there are three screws. I mean, we see six screws, but we only need to have the three screws. It would say this and this one that we need to loosen only. But before doing anything, it will be fine. This is just a dentist tool, or you could use a some pointy metal thingy, needle or something, and simply make a scratch here. Yeah, right, a scratch, so you can see it where the lens has been before you take it apart. So by setting a mark here as a reference, because this ring will not turn when you turn the focusing ring, but the plate out here, we simply need to set a mark. And just for safety, I also set a mark here. It would just be so it more simple to see. Well, it's also good to set a mark here on the actual plastic, Yeah, it is plastic. On the plastic focusing ring in here, because if we no, when we loosen the two screw, the three screws, the focusing ring itself, the plastic part, will move. And that's the idea with it. So, I will just loosen it, just a few turns, not necessary to fully unscrew. So, and from now on, the focusing plastic ring is actually loose. It will say the focusing helicoid will not at all move until I press. But I want to actually go to the I mean set the helicoid to go to let's say, I mean, if it's set on 10 and that's my infinity, I would like to have it all the way over to infinity. So by pressing on here, simply press on the outside of the, I mean, on the front of the focusing ring, one can actually move the, as you can see here, when pressing, I can actually move my helicoid. So it will come all the way over to infinity, the mark here. And now I simply adjust my infinity to something else. It could be different in your camera depending on what adapter you have or which camera you have. So, and if I want to do it back again, okay, it was not correct. I can just press in here and move the infinity back to what it was. So, and you can actually move it a lot. There is a stop when you move the plastic focusing ring. It will go all the way over to here, to infinity. But the helicoid, it can actually move a little further. So if I just move the focusing ring a bit and then turn the actual helicoid, it can go all the way over to, well, as much as possible. Because I set a mark here, that's the actual stop. If you move it further, as long as it can, you can see, okay, it cannot come any longer. You have a different problem. It will say the aperture will not at all move because it's actually stuck by the back of the lens in here. So I have to turn it a little counterclockwise, just a little. That's why I set a mark here. And now, well, it needs a little bit more. And now I can actually, well, needs a little more. It depending on, hold on, we need to do so. That's my infinity and that there. And if I move it all the way almost to the black dot, you can see it was not even that far, so it's actually here. But it's quite a bit. See, it loosened up. So that's very important to know. You do not have unlimited movement of the infinity. So it's only a fine tuning of the focusing ring with the inner, I mean the focusing helicoid. So now it would be actually focus way beyond infinity if I set it all that way over here. Remember, I was here with my 10 meter. So I would like to have it to infinity mark on the focusing ring. So I go out a little and adjust it there. I already have checked where my infinity is when I put it on my camera and the mount here. So, whoa, where's my red dot here? So it should be very simple to do. And just remember, do not put it too much over to infinity. You see, the closer the lens assembly will go to the sensor, the deeper into the lens body it will be. If we look here, set it to something there, and then see on the back, here was my original infinity. So it's almost flush here. But if I set it to as long as it can, it will say the first white dot here, set it all the way over to here. It's a bit out of the mount here. So it's quite a bit. But we will just set it to here, because that's my new infinity. And that we only need to do is to gently tighten the screws. And that was actually that. And my aperture will still work as it should. So how about that? That was actually very simple. So I can just put my name ring on again and say, okay, now my lens is adjusted to infinity. And then tighten the front ring with a rubber stopper here, or whatever lens tool you will use. So that's it. Very simple. So hope you can use the info about this. So that was all for me. Bye bye.